I am Anjana Haresh Motwani, CEO of HP International. Our company deals in PVC solvent cement, mainly from adhesive family, but used for PVC pipes and fitting of various types. Basically, honesty, quality of product, commitment towards my customers, and welfare of my labor and staff. My company has dominated this industry for the last 4 decades. The only reason towards it is that I'm very conscious about the quality of my product, honesty, commitment towards my customers, and definitely welfare of my labor and staff. My husband was working for an ex-pipe company, and when a foreign collaborator offered that to their company, the directors were not interested because it was a very small turnover business then. Then the same product was offered to us on individual basis, and we grabbed this opportunity, and from that day till today, there's no going back on it. I'm proud to announce that I have more than 500 clients, and we have been successfully able to satisfy them because we have a very set-in admin system which looks into the smallest aspects, right from quality to purchase to logistics to timely delivery, and that's kept us going on, and we want to keep on improvising it till we and give further satisfaction to all of our customers. Well, my husband was the one who always felt ladies can do greater jobs. So he floated this ladies wing. BIA, the full form is Bombay Industries Association. I was fortunate to be the first president. And my only motive there was to make all the ladies coming from high-end business houses to achieve something in life, start some business, and not be just labeled as housemaker. Basically, I am not a honestly page 3 person. I am a grassroots level person, and for the welfare of my village, I have opened a school there, a clinic there, some water tanks we have established there, and every time there is something new required to be done in our village, which is where my factory is situated, I just go ahead and do it. I would like to convey a small message to all the ladies like me who started from small, that there is no substitute for hard work. And if we are focused, we have set goals and we have ambitions, nothing can stop us from achieving it. But yes, we have to work hard. In today's men world, we shouldn't feel that we are a weaker sex. We are achievers and fighters, and we can prove it only with our hard work. I do agree that, you know, initially in this male-dominated society, women are not given that importance. Rather, they don't trust us. But once we prove our point, there is no ending to it. And a simple example I can set is that these days, after my so many years of business, people have found that I have achieved a level in my life. The men also come forward and tell me, Mrs. Motwani, can you advise us on this? And sometimes they send up their daughters, go and study something under her, go and learn something from her. Sometimes they even tell their wives, why don't you do what Mrs. Motwani is doing? So this is a proud moment that I had a vision, I was hardworking, I had set goals for myself, and I have achieved it. And a lot of contribution, if you tell me, has come from my husband, my son now, who's presently joined me in business. And of course, I cannot forget my labor, my staff, my family of Motwanis and Shahs, who have been always very, very encouraging for me to reach this stage in my life where I feel I am at the top, and I feel very proud about my achievements and myself. I started this business where my first delivery was only of 30 liters, which was made by me and one of the workers, and of course overlooked by my husband, who gave us the formulation. But I'm very, very happy and proud that 30 liters changed my life, because from that day till today, there is no going back. I remember the first day I got 200 liters, my husband just took me out for a big grand celebration. He's saying, oh, you have achieved. Today, I think we are doing daily more than about 40-50 tons of the same material. I started from a small unit of 300 square feet. Today my entire establishment is in 6.5 acres. But I don't take this entire, you know, achievement as me alone, because there are so many people who have, you know, contributed to this level of my success. To start with, my husband was very encouraging and pushy. Of course, he is not with me to see this final success, but in his time also we were very successful. Now my son has joined me just 4 years back, and he has brought multiple bounds and leaps may my success, where I have to be very, very proud of him being the mother. I cannot forget my labor class. I have to mention one very important thing. When I was going through the crisis, when my husband was sick for 2 months, we were not in India, but my staff or my labor did not call back to give me any sort of pressure. In fact, when I would call up, they'll say, "You take care of Saab, don't worry about us." That was the proudest moment for me. The contribution also came in a very, very big way from my vendors and suppliers, who would be very keen in supplying. Of course, we were also known paymasters. But still, you know, when they come forward, if there is a change of prices expected, this, that, even today they'll say, "Madam, please purchase, there is likelihood of revision of prices." So I was supported that way. And I cannot forget my customers also, you know, who are our backbone. Customers are always the backbone of any industry. And, you know, I don't remember any customer having been rude. We have rarely got, you know, claims of anything, but still they would come and explain us what went wrong and sit with us to decide why it went wrong. We have a big establishment and a very big, you know, QC lab. And at every stage, I make sure that my product is tested, but still you encounter some problems at time. Even, you know, and throughout the journey of 30 years, I should say, right from officers, right from various licensing department, there were always ups and downs. You know, some officers wouldn't cooperate, some officers would just wait for finding faults. But I think this aspect I was handling more because my husband was mainly, looking into sales. And I found that you have to sit with them, explain them correctly, and the things go on. Touch wood, in 30 years I have never encountered any departmental inquiries or any such problems with any department. And yes, of course, being a lady, they never took me seriously initially, but then they realized today many big officers or many senior officers they are good friend of mine, and today also I can call upon them for any advice, and they are all there to help me. I again give all my achievement credit to my husband, my son, my family of Shahs and Motwanis, my staff, my labor, my vendors, and of course my customers. I'm very connected to my labor. To be very honest, I can sit with them and have their lunch also. We have a special system where I have insured each and every labor, even if he's a daily worker, for Mediclaim individual policies. We have education loan. Any worker's child wants to study till the bachelor's, we provide them funds. I give house loan. I'm known as house lady. They expect house loan funds, which we give. But we have a very, very important aspects in my factory, that is award system. By award system is that we have different types of awards every month, where somebody becomes an achiever, we put his photograph, and you know, that gives a motivation to other workers to achieve that position for the next month. So this has been a very success story. Then we have a couple of, you know, functions like Dashera is a big celebration, and we entire people, you know, everybody is at same level. That is the day my staff can talk against me, they can fight with me, they can, you know, express what they have liked, disliked about me, and nothing is carried forward except that I try to improvise. Then we have a yearly trip for the entire workers, where they decide the place and we all go together for a trip for a day or two. And you know, I'm very socially and morally attached to them because I always felt I exist because of them. We were fortunate enough, as I mentioned to you earlier also, that we got the foreign collaboration and we grabbed it, and that was our start story. Today also we have foreign formulations from very, very renowned and known people of this industry, overseas as well as in India. My inspiration and motivators, I already mentioned, is my husband, my son, my family of Motwanis and Shah, my labor, my staff, my vendors, my customers, because I think motivation and is not a one word or a one stroke thing. It comes in various respect, in various types, in various modes, and you know, somewhere or other, it's how we take it and I get motivated is a very individual factor, but I think all of them have helped me to reach this stage. The definition of any success or anyone's success or any company's success is hard work, ambition, goal. And once you have ambition and will to achieve it, you are a successful person. My expectation for my next generation is whatever may come, you have to work honestly, be quality conscious and true to yourself, to your business and to the society as a whole. Because if everyone thinks about only themselves and not society, it doesn't work. I think a lady plays three roles if she is a career lady. She has to look after family, society requirements are always there, social norms, and of course business. I have been successful and I can tell that to people that you need to only time manage your day. You have to designate certain time to the family, to your business and to social networking or whatever social norm and requirements are there, society's norms and requirements. And I found that it was not difficult because when I'm working, I'm just working. When I'm with my children, when they were just born or young, I never sat back home. Though I took care of my children, I'm sure if you question them, they'll be proud to announce that I did not miss out on any of their important dates, functions, or teaching them anything in life. Time management, as we would call, it takes you to a great level. Like when I devoted time to family, I wouldn't talk business. When I'm in office, I wouldn't let any of my family unwantedly call me up because I would like to concentrate on that. When I'm at a social function, I would be concentrating on that. And I am a social worker in my circle where I go out and help people also. But I feel if one can really manage time, and as I told to you, I'm not a page 3 person. I don't attend kitty parties. But my concentration on life was family, business and society or my circle whom I'm close to. So I feel everybody can achieve if they can little bit plan out their time for every aspects of their life which are must and not avoidable.